Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are fine. Children, in your PT1 courses, there are two chapters in your computer. And today I am going to start your second chapter. The name of the chapter is More About Windows 7. Okay children, let's start our today's chapter.
More About Windows 7. It is your second chapter. In the previous class, we have learned that computer system is made up of hardware and software. One of the most widely used and user-friendly operating system is Windows. Now let's learn more about Windows 7. In this chapter, dear student, we will learn about Windows desktop, setting wallpaper and screensaver, working with files and folders in Windows Explorer. We will broadly discuss each topic in our presentations. Now, I am going to start your first topic, that is Windows Desktop. Windows Desktop. When we switch on the computer, it starts by booting. After the booting process is over, the first screen that appears on the monitor screen is called Windows Desktop. Children, when we switch on our computer, it starts by booting and it will take time. After the booting process is over, the first screen that we see on the monitor screen is called Windows Desktop. Windows Desktop is a computer display area that represents the kinds of objects. A desktop can be contained in a window that is part of the total display area or can be full screen. The small pictures that we see on the desktop are called icons. And with the help of icons, we can open different program, files, folders by double-clicking on it with the mouse. Children, this is the basic concept of Windows Desktop. Now we will move to our next topic, that is setting wallpaper and screensaver. Dear student, in this topic, we will learn what is wallpaper, what is screensaver, and after that we will learn how we can set this wallpaper and screensaver on your desktop. Now we will first start what is wallpaper. A wallpaper or background is a digital image used as a decorative background or a graphical user interface on the screen of a computer. On a computer, wallpapers are generally used on the desktop. Children, what is wallpaper? A wallpaper is the picture or the background image that we see when you start our computer on the desktop. Windows 7 has a number of wallpapers and also we can download wallpapers from the internet. We can even put our own pictures on the desktop wallpaper. What is screensaver? A screensaver is a computer program that blanks to the screen or fills to the screen with the moving images or patterns. When the computer has been idle for a long period of time. Children, what is screensaver? A screensaver is an image which is activated on the screen when we do not use a computer for a period of time. Windows 7 has a number of screensavers which we can use. Screensavers are used for security purposes. These are the basic concept of wallpaper and screensaver. Now we will go to our next slide, that is how we can set wallpaper and screensaver. Setting wallpaper. To set a wallpaper, we can follow the following steps. First, choose Start. Second, go to the Control Panel, Appearance and Personalizations, and Desktop Background. Two number is Choose a location from the picture location drop-down list and click the picture or color that you want for your background. 3. Number is choose an option from the picture positions drop-down list. Children, to set a wallpaper, we can follow the following steps. First, click on the start button. After the start menu appears, click on control panel button. After clicking on control panel button, we see that appearance and personalizations option is there. We go to that options and click on it. Under personalizations, click on change desktop background. After that, select the pictures. There is more pictures. You can select any one pictures according to your choice. After that, click on save changes button. Save changes button, one option is there. You go to that options and click on it. Lastly, the selected pictures will appear as your desktop background. And this is the procedure. We can follow this procedure for setting a wallpaper. Now we will move to our next topic, that is setting screensaver. To set a screensaver, we can follow the following steps. First one is right click on the desktop and choose personalizations option. Two number is click on the screensaver button. Step 3 is from the screensaver drop down list, choose a screensaver. Fourth is click the preview button to preview your screensaver of choice. Fifth one is click to stop the preview, click OK and then click close button. Dear children, what is the procedure to set a screensaver? First of all, click on the start button. After the start menu appears, click on control panel button. Step 2 is click the appearance and personalizations options. Under the personalizations, click on the change screensaver. Select the screensaver of your choice from the drop-down list. There is more screensaver. You can select any one screensaver according to your choice. Select the time after which you want the screensaver to activate in the wait box. And lastly, you can apply button is there. You can click on the apply button and then click on OK button. That is the procedure to set a screensaver on your desktop. Now we will go to our next topic, that is working with files and folder. Children, in this topic we will learn about files and folder, and after that how this file and folder we can work with this file and folder in Windows Explorer we will discuss later. So let's start. What is file and folder? File is the work done on a computer is stored in the form of files, and folder is a folder is like an almira where all the files are kept. File is the work done on a computer stored in the form of files. That means all the works that we have done on a computer, all are stored in the form of files. Each file is given a file name that helps us to find it easily. And folder is like an almira. Folder is called an almira. We know that in an almira, where we kept all our necessary documents, materials, etc., etc. So, a folder is also called an almira. That means here we can kept all our necessary files. That means all the files are kept in a folder. A single folder is a collection of related files. So, these are the basic concepts of file and folders. Now, we will move to our next topic. Our next topic is open a file or folder. In this topic, we will learn how we will open a file and folder. Children, there are two steps. To follow these steps, we can open a file or folder. Step 1 is, in the left pane, click on any folder. Step 2 is, in the right pane, click on any folder or file to view its content. That means, in the left pane, click on any folder. Whatever you want, you can select this folder and click on it. Step 1. And step 2 is, click on any folder or file to view its content. That means, after clicking, we can see or view the contents of this file or folder. These are the two basic steps to open a file or a folder. Now we will move to our next topic. Let's see what is our next topic. That is deleting a file or folder. In this topic, we will learn that how we can delete a file or folder. Okay? There are also two steps. To follow the steps and we can delete this file or folder. Let's see what are the steps. Step 1 is, select the file or folder you want to delete. Step 2 is, click on the organize button and select the delete options. That means, step 1 is, select the file or folder you want to delete. If you want to delete a file and folder, first of all you can select which file you want to delete. Select that file or folder. And after that, click on the organize button. There is one organize button. Options is there. You go to that organize button and click on it. And select the delete options. After that, you can select the delete options and delete your file or folder. These are the basic concepts of file and folder. How we can open file, how we can delete file, how we are working these files and folders in Windows Explorer. So, I hope this video will benefit you. Thank you so much.